This is serendipity. She's my gorgeous baby swamp wallaby. A baby kangaroo and a wallaby is called a joey. And of course, swamp wallabies are a marsupial, which means they have a short gestation period and the baby grows up in a pouch. Swamp wallabies are macropods. Macro meaning big and pod meaning foot. They have huge clod-hopping feet. Scientific name is Wallabia bicolor, which means two-toned wallaby. Swamp wallabies have less chromosomes than eastern grey kangaroos. Macropus species have 16 chromosomes, where swamp wallabies, the males, they have 11 chromosomes, where the female only has 10. That's why they're still regarded as a separate genus, Wallabia. Swamp wallabies are much more solitary than the eastern grey kangaroo. They generally like to live by themselves. The sure tell sign that you have swamp wallabies living in your neck of the woods is look out for their droppings. Look at those big ears for listening for danger, and well adapted at grabbing its food with its front feet. Wallabies don't just eat grass, they eat bark and shrubs as well, also known to eat fungi. Interesting fact, swamp wallabies can consume bracken and hemlock, toxic plants to livestock and human beings. These animals are cathemeral, which means that they come out day and night time. They generally like to live by themselves or in small family groups. Look at this huge tail. It's like a tightroper's pole, perfect for balance and changing directions as they hop around the bush at night time. Can you see their syndactylous claw on their toe? They use their claw like a hairbrush to comb their hair. Swamp wallabies are often called stink wallabies. If you work with swamp wallabies, you know they can give off a very pongy smell. Woo-wee! Oh. The biggest threat to swamp wallabies in Manningham is loss of habitat. We all need to work together to create more habitat and more linking corridors so these wallabies can bound around our suburbs. Another big threat are dogs. People walking their dogs off leashes. Dogs often chase our wallabies. Feral foxes love eating wallabies. They get hit by our cars. So slow down dusk and dawn. That's when swamp wallabies are most active. Swamp wallabies have a gestation period between 33 and 38 days, whereas human beings are 40 weeks. Did you know that swamp wallabies can conceive whilst they're still pregnant? Very few animals in the world can do that. Swamp wallabies employ a very unique reproductive strategy. It's called embryonic diapause. Swamp wallabies love thick undergrowth. That's where they feel safest. Swamp wallabies in Manningham live along our creeks and streams and the Yarra River. They love secluded places. This beautiful Australian macropod has a lot of pressure to face. They won't be here forever if we don't do the right thing. So get on board. Plant some native grasses for our swamp wallabies in Manningham. We need to protect our wildlife together.